Michael, he's a perfectionist. He's he wants the best, and he'll work hard at getting the best.
Growing up in Gary, Indiana, our house was the size of a two-car garage, not even that big. And I can't believe, we had one bathroom. Tito and I slept at the top, Michael and Marlon slept in the middle, and Jackie was at the bottom getting all the showers. We had a washing machine that we would pull out in the middle of the floor, and this washing machine would make this noise. Michael used to stand by the washing machine, and it made this kind of beat, and he was in his diaper, sucking his bottle, and he was just shaking to the beat of the washing machine. My mother used to watch him, and she said, he's got rhythm. Tito was sneaking in the closet playing my father's guitar, and then he broke one of the strings. Right. My father came home and saw what had happened, so he said, who played my guitar? And Tito said, I did. So he said, well, show me what you know how to do. So we started playing the guitar, and then we started singing, and that's how it all started. From that point on, he started taking money that's supposed to have been to repair the house, putting it to us with equipment and this and that. And so Michael and Michael was just wanting to be in the group. And we said, you're too young. And all of a sudden, my mother's mother said, let him in the group. We put him in the group, and it was over. I was the lead singer first. And when he started singing, and he started watching James Brown and Joe Tex and all these people and Sammy Davis and Jackie Wilson, It was over. He could watch something and do it. And that's how he patterned himself.
How many years of your life have you been a performer?
I guess ever since I was 11.
Who have you learned from?
I've learned from all of my father-in-law, my brothers, Barry White, Stevie Wonder, on and on.
My mother and father are the reason why we're really what we are today. They led a very strong, they gave us a strong foundation and a great direction.
I remember having a paper route and and delivering papers, getting chased by dogs, and even going to the laundromat, pushing a cart down on the street with our clothes and inside the laundromat with a box of Tide washing powder. But those were the days that I'll never forget, because that prepared me and also my brothers and my whole entire family. And I say it time and time, if you don't forget where you come from, you always know where you're going.
We've always had a connection when we were young in elementary school, and my father, us being the lead singers in the Jackson 5 way before the success of just around our local home in Gary, Indiana, doing talent shows, and us being the two lead singers, there was always a bond between us. All your brothers there, and you're on stage, you know what Michael's going to do, you know what Jackie's going to do with Tito's, because Michael was always on my right. So
yeah.
And we kind of play off of each other, but it's been like that since we were very young.
So. Yeah.
The Jackson 5 years is so special to me, Tito, Marlon, Jackie. Why? Because we set the stage for everything to happen. And him, myself, and Marlon, we used to get into a lot of crazy things and go to hotels and throw things out the windows and do crazy stuff. And our best moments were before the show, ordering up everything. Ice cream, pie, trying to eat as much as you can before you get on stage. I go back on the years when we were the Jackson 5 and we were just kids and how hard we worked and just kids with a dream of just wanting to get on stage and do our thing and then never knowing what's in store. Well, you know, my father is responsible for that, because he made us
rehearse. Yeah.
And you have to be the best. Yeah, well, we were always rehearsing as kids, and my father training us and really preparing us.
Getting the respect from us at an early age, and it had a lot to do with whippings and chores and responsibilities at an early age. It was very important to them to have us to, you know, clean behind ourselves and know how to press our own clothes and clean house and do for ourselves.
Michael asks you, would you cry if Joseph died? What did Michael say after he asked you that question?
He said he don't know if he would or he wouldn't.
You said you were haunted by the screams of Michael the first time he was hit by your father with a switch.
Not so much of petrified, but just the excitement of him not understanding what it means. He wanted to show us, I care about you. Even if I have to whip your butt, I care about you. I'm gonna keep you off those streets.
And when you sort of last year you were vying on the charts, I asked this once before, but you didn't really sort of tell me. Did you and Michael get together and say, oh, look, you know, I'm number one this week and you're number one next week?
No, well, the timing was just perfect. His album was out before mine, and mine came out. Right. I guess we both hit the charts at the same time.
Well, I deal with the worldly things, the older crowds, and just what's real, what's out there. Michael deals with that too, but his is more of something that's gonna sell, something that's commercial, something that's a thing or a fad or something that people can just lock into. I guess my position coming from as a writer from that angle is because of what Stevie Wonder has done. I just think that he's the greatest songwriter. And a lot of stuff that Marvin Gaye did. I mean, they wrote about world problems. They wrote about, you know, love and this and that. But still, it's something that people say that that's reality. That's universal.
Right.
And it's something that we've seen happen before.
What is it, 1984 to 1992? You saw Michael maybe three times a year during that period?
Yes.
You sent him letters?
Yes.
Packages, but he never responded to any of them?
No.
Why didn't he want to see you, Jermaine?
It's not that he didn't want to see me.
He could have picked up the phone and seen me anytime he wanted.
No, Michael don't call.
It's pretty much of the public sometimes who wants to create rivalry and this and that, but what we try to do is just do our best. And when we come together as a unit, that's when you really see that it's a family unit. It's important for Michael to do well. It's important for me to do well.
Jermaine, as I think you know, on this program last September, your sister LaToya said...
Jermaine is definitely jealous of him. I mean, it's very blatant that he's very jealous of Michael, or anybody that succeeds in that matter in the family.
That's ridiculous. Who has not had success in my family? We were the Jackson Five. Every song Michael sung on, I sung on. We helped build what's going on right now. It's not about that.
They want to forget, but the Jackson Five is what gave Michael and Janet the platform to do what they did. And the Jackson Five, to this day, there's no other act in the history of the business that was unknown and came out with four number one records in a row, knocked the Beatles out of number one spot twice, and never had a Grammy. Michael comes from a family. He comes from the Jackson family. And when he hurts, we hurt. When he does great, we all do great. When he does bad, we all do bad. So we're a family. And I just don't like it when they try to separate him from us, because we all started together. And it could have been a lot of influence from outside people saying, your family's gonna hold you back.
Once the act gets so big, there's so many people that come around, the legal people and everyone, and they sort of almost pull you away. So it's important for us to continue to be a family and to stay together, because the divide and conquer.
There were just times when we just didn't see eye to eye on things, because I wanted him to not get so far away from the family because of the success. Mm-hmm. And so we had meetings and stuff, and I said, listen, I'm just not here because of me. It's Rebe, Jackie, this one and that one. And we need to be close because the success with the Thriller album and this and that, all those things, and then it brought on all these other people who wanted to become his brothers, his sisters, his mother, his father. That's what my concerns were.
And we're still one big family, meaning no matter how far we go in life, we're still one big family. We're still, the Garaniana is still our home, and that's very important.
Success is not the most important. What's the most important, the fact that we had each other before success and was here on his couch.
yes.
is more important than success. Money mm-hmm. comes and it goes.
Exactly. Yeah.
But we'll always have each other.
Any place when people want to come around you for the wrong reason, that's mm-hmm. why you keep people around you who were there before, the true friends. It's that's not beautiful. About the money, it's about the heart, who care. Well, what's untold is pretty much that we love each other and we feel each other all the time. It's just the business has created so much of us having to go here. So we're always in different places. We find it hard to all be in one place at the same time. We're brothers. And if I have a beef with Michael like anybody else, it blows up. But sometimes they get on my nerves, I get on their nerves. It's just brothers. We came out to Hollywood as a tree, and my father fought so hard to keep us together, the parable of the tree. They're the root system, and we're the different branches. Hollywood did not look at the tree for its beauty. They looked at the tree for individual branches, for their own selfish greed. And that was my father's fight to keep us together. And that was the most important thing, the parable of the sticks in the book. He put five sticks together, he couldn't break them. Took one, he broke it. He said, this is you guys if you don't stay together.